start your presentation.
Oke. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning to Prof. Usman, Miss Filia, and other friend. Today we will presentation. We will give a presentation about our topic, which is bulimia nervosa. We are from group 5, consists of Grace Marenta, myself Ilham Rizky Akbar, and Marlen. Next. These are the table of contents that we will deliver to you about bulimia nervosa. The first one is about the disease, the second one is the symptom, the third one is causes, the fourth one is anorexia versus bulimia, the fifth is treatment, and the last one is metabolic abnormalities of bulimia nervosa. Next. The first one is about the disease. What is bulimia nervosa? Bulimia nervosa, or what we often call bulimia, is a serious potentially life-threatening eating disorder characterized by a cycle of binging and compensatory behavior. So they are eat a lot, and usually they are compensatory behavior that from their eating, so their body doesn't get a lot of food. Okay, next one. There are two types of bulimia. The first one is followed by self-induced vomiting or misuse of laxative or diuretics. The second type is non-purging type, when the binge episode is followed by excessive exercise or fasting. The first one is purging type. Purging behaviors are common in bulimia nervosa, with self-inflicted vomiting seen as the most frequent purging behavior. Usually, people with bulimia who feel purged feel a compulsive need to do so and a sense of relief after purging. The purging type of bulimia can be harmful to an individual health. The consequence of purging depend on the method of purging employed. Usually, people with purging type of bulimia, they are have a cycle of purging in usually at least once a week for 3 months. And the extreme can be almost every day for about 6 months or a year. The next one? Next one is non-purging type. People with non-purging bulimia use other behavior like exercise or fasting to compensate for food consumed, but their exercise or fasting usually very, very extreme or excessive, like only fasting, only drink water or exercise a lot, but too much and extreme. Okay, next. Which one is worse? In some ways, the health risks of purging behavior can carry more immediate risks the non-purging, like severe dehydration or electrolyte imbalance. It's usually caused by vomiting or, like I mentioned before, like using laxative or diuretics. So they carry more immediate risk than non-purging type. On the other hand, non-purging type bulimia, where exercise or fast still experience significant distress, guilt, or impaired functioning. Despite this difference, expert cautions against calling one version of bulimia worse than another. Both type of bulimia are linked with short and long-term consequences. So they are not worse than another, but they are equally bad for our health. Okay, next one.
Are the symptoms of bulimia nervosa? So bulimia signs and symptoms are being preoccupied with your body shape and weight, living in fear of gaining weight. Next is repeated episodes of eating abnormally large amount of food in one sitting. feeling a lost control during binging, like cannot stop eating or cannot control what they eat. The next one is they usually force to vomit or exercising too much to keep them from gaining weight after binging. They also using laxative, diuretics, or enemas when they're not necessarily needed. Fasting, restricting calories, or avoiding certain foods between binges. And last is they are using dietary supplements or herbal products excessively. So if someone has any bulimia symptoms, it will be better to seek medical help as soon as possible. Because if bulimia is left untreated, it can severely impact your health then, and this will be further explained in metabolic abnormalities.
And then there are several factors that can causes of bulimia nervosa. But actually, the exact cause of bulimia is unknown. But many factors can play a role in the development of eating disorders, including genetics, biology, emotional health, social expectation, and other issues. For girls and women are more likely to have bulimia than boys and men. Bulimia often begins in the late teens or early adulthood. And then there are several factors that can increase risk of bulimia that include first is biological. Although there is non-specific gene associated with bulimia nervosa, a familial component appears to be present in the development or of eating disorders. Like first degree relative, like parents, siblings, or children of individuals with an eating disorders are more likely to develop an eating disorder for that individuals than the general public, because it suggesting a possible genetic link. And then the second is psychological and emotional issues. Psychological and emotional problems like depression, anxiety disorders, feel negatively about themselves, and in some cases, traumatic event and environmental stress may be contributing factors. The last is from dieting. People who diet are at higher risk of developing eating disorders because people who diet severely restrict calories between binge episodes, which may trigger an urge to again binge eat, and then purge again. Other triggers from binging can include stress, poor body self-image, poor and boredom. Next.
Moving on to the difference between anorexia and bulimia. So, anorexia and bulimia are both eating disorders and both are serious conditions. The main difference is that people with anorexia are usually underweight, where people with bulimia is abnormal or overweight. And then second, people with anorexia take in few calories as they have several food restriction and extreme starvation. Meanwhile, people with bulimia have heavy meals followed by purging or excessive exercise. And lastly, both people with anorexia and bulimia are obsessed with weight and appearance, but people with anorexia believe she or he is fat even when she or he is really underweight.
There are several ways that can be done to treat someone who have bulimia nervosa. The first one is prevention. It can be done by have a regular meal time as often as possible, and it would be better if having meal with family. And second is try to don't talk about weight, instead focus on healthy habits, and then try to promote a healthy, realistic body image, and discourage fat dieting. And for the medical treatment, there are two types. First one is medication, and then second one is hospitalization. For medication, the doctors usually give the antidepressant fluoxetine that was approved for the treatment of bulimia. Doctors sometimes recommend other antidepressant or type of medicines. And for hospitalization, it just suggested by doctor for serious cases of bulimia. And it doesn't happen often, but with serious case of bulimia, people might be treated in a hospital for a long time. Most eating disorder programs offer outpatient treatment. And then there are some types of therapy. The first one is cognitive behavior therapy. In this therapy, people learn normal eating habits and watch out for the things that lead to binge or purge. And then people challenge irrational thoughts and unhealthy behavior as they arise. For the second is family-based treatment. So it is often used in children and teens with bulimia, and it helps the family deal with the illness and the issues that it can cause. And the third is interpersonal physicotherapy. This focus on problems in relationship with other people in life. The way we interact with others can affect our emotional state and mental health. The fourth is nutritional therapy. The goal is to teach about eating habits. Work with a dietitian to learn to recognize body signal of hunger and fullness. And they help stabilize weight and gain the healthier attitude toward food. The last is self-care of bulimia. Include healthy foods in our diet to make sure that we are getting the nutrients we need, and connect with others so we can overcome the unhealthy habits and feel better about ourselves. Next.
So next we will discuss about the metabolic abnormalities. The first one is ketoacidosis. Ketoacidosis is an acidosis caused by high blood concentration of ketone bodies. And this an extremely dangerous condition that can lead to sudden coma and death when high acid level build up in your blood. There are three ketone bodies produced by the liver. There are acetoacetate, beta-hydroxybutyric acid, and acetone. As we already learned in lipid metabolism before, ketosis may occur during starvation because of pure carbohydrate intake, which leads to lipolysis and ketogenesis, where the brain and other tissues use ketone bodies as an alternative energy source instead of glucose. And as we can see in the picture, a metabolic pathway that produces ketone bodies is called ketogenesis. First, two molecules of acetyl-CoA are condensed to form acetoacetyl-CoA by the enzyme thiolase. And then the next step, which is catalyzed by HMG-CoA synthase, acetoacetyl-CoA will be combined with acetyl-CoA to produce HMG-CoA. And then one acetyl-CoA is cleaved by HMG-CoA lyase, producing acetoacetate. And acetoacetate can now either be reduced to D-beta hydroxybutyrate or undergo spontaneous decarboxylation to form acetone.
And the second one is metabolic alkalosis. Metabolic alkalosis is the condition, the metabolic state where the body's pH is elevated to greater than 7.45 to some metabolic process. The plasma of bicarbonate rise to up to an abnormally high level. In this case, is higher than 28 milliequivalent per liter. And there are two main categories of metabolic alkalosis. The first one is sodium chloride responsive, where patients with bulimia nervosa, most of them is included in sodium chloride responsive, and the second one is sodium chloride unresponsive. And for the metabolic process in patient with bulimia nervosa. Actually, usually patient with bulimia nervosa used to purge with excessive vomiting, and it can cause the sodium chloride is lost when they are do vomiting. So it can decrease the intravascular volume, which in turn increases proximal renal tubular reabsorption of sodium as sodium bicarbonate. Because the sodium bicarbonate is increased, and it can make the body will be more basic. So it can until the final step is the body is till the metabolic alkalosis, and then vomiting or sodium chloride loss, it can be stimulates the renin angiotensin system and adrenal aldosterone secretion that can elevate the serum bicarbonate. So it can be another way to make it to form the metabolic alkalosis. And the third one is about electrolyte imbalance. So electrolytes are minor minerals in the body that when are in imbalance or disrupted can lead to various side effects. Up to 49% of individuals with severe symptoms of bulimia have imbalance electrolytes such as sodium and potassium. People with bulimia tend to do vomiting and then being dehydrated. And dehydration and vomiting can lead to some imbalance of electrolyte in the body, like there is a table of electrolyte and acid-base change in associated with purging. When people do vomiting, the sodium and potassium, also chloride will decrease, but the bicarbonate will increase, and it can cause metabolic acidosis and metabolic alkalosis. And electrolyte imbalance also can affect people in their heartbeats and possibly to cause heart failure and death.
The fourth one is hypo and hyperglycemia. Hyperglycemia is a high blood glucose or blood sugar, happen when the body has too little insulin or when the body can use insulin properly. And hypoglycemia is condition in which your blood sugar or glucose level is lower than normal. People with bulimia have a tendency to binge on food that are high in sugar and fat. Even though they are purged the food, some will remain in the body, which can cause development of diabetes mellitus type 2, which is happen when the sugar is in the blood is too much and the insulin can process the sugar. Bulimia with binging and vomiting can also cause hypoglycemia and after glucose level. It also often occur when with people with non-binging bulimia, like when they are excessive exercise or excessive fasting, so they are having a low level of glucose in their blood. Okay, the next one. The next one is another effect of bulimia. There are some other disease can occur when they are having bulimia. The first one is seizure. Bulimia sufferers have a higher chance of suffering from seizures. The next one is pancreatitis. It can be caused by the excessive use of laxative or diet pills. The third one is depression. Bulimia is exhausting and cause depressing. Usually it's because the pressure that they give themselves about their weight, body, and their look. The fourth one is cardiac arrest. It is the one of the most common cause of death from bulimia. The next one is gastric rupture. Can occur when you eat huge amount of during a binge, and it can be burst your stomach. The last one is Barrett's esophagus. Bulimia can cause gastroesophageal reflux disease. This can lead to a condition called Barrett's esophagus. Okay, this is the reference that we use for our presentation. Thank you for listening.